first started as on call, I was part of a different union, and I didn't really get much information, or I didn't take the time to read my book. I didn't know there was a book. I didn't know there was a contract. I didn't know there was, like Tommia was saying earlier, like rules that needed to be abided by or followed. And so when I had my rep at the call center, like there were times during our team meetings that she would sit down and like let us know, like, this is what's happening, you know, if you guys have any questions, this is a book. And so her example was definitely something that prompt me to become that leader, just because, like I said before, you know, I've always wanted to like be there for others and care for others. So that was like a way of me advocating for like my brothers and sisters, to have that information that maybe I didn't have when I first started.
It was like, well, I started at one facility where I had a steward that would, like she said, educate us, keep us informed. And when I transitioned to another facility, it was like, no, we can't do this, we can't do that, the union contract says that, and it was just conflicting. And I was like, no, they don't know the contract, or people are not educated in regards to the contract over here. And so I know someone helped me through that process, and so that's what prompted me to be a steward, to help other people to learn the contract, to make sure we help hold management accountable for to the contract.
Okay.
You know, so that's what made me do that.
And if I can share my story too, what prompted me to become a union leader is that my sheer ignorance of everything in the beginning. I was not aware that there were two contracts. I wasn't aware that there was a national agreement. I heard of the Purple Book, but never saw it and never opened it. I guess I was of the mindset that didn't care, right? Just give me what you're going to give me, and I'm happy with it. But I must say that over the course of few years, I was approached, and I've seen some of the union leaders operate, and like coming from a non-union environment and seeing that, hey, you know, these agreements were written, placed in this book so we can all abide by, where labor and management came together and said, signed off on it and said, yes, these are going to be the working conditions, and then realize that there are things that you can actually fall back on. I mean, it's so important that even simple as discipline, coming from a non-union environment, if you get discipline, right, that, you know, it's at will, right? So if you mess up, you're out of there, right? There are no stages, right? There is no progressive discipline, right? So for me, realizing that it's just not, you know, cut and dry and you're out of here, you know, there's actually a process, right? And so understand that there is a process to say, hey, I want to be a steward, as it's stated, right? I want to be able to uphold that process, the agreements, to make sure that management is in line with labor and making sure things are fair and equitable, right? So now that you both are union leaders, what advice would you give to a new employee who's coming on board for the very first time being in the union job? What would you say?
Learn your contract. Pick up your book. Because you don't want to miss out on anything that you deserve, that you're supposed to have. It's so much in there that will be beneficial to you. So I would say learn the contract. That's the part that a lot of people lack, is learning the contract.
And you, Marissa?
I would say also, like, make sure you're educated on what your rights are, you know, the contract, what you know, benefits it offers you, but also staying engaged. Like, if there's CREs, make sure you attend them. If the, you know, somebody from the union comes to your department, make sure you're asking questions. Like, that's how I got started. I got even more involved, like Tommia was saying. At first, I didn't see myself as a leader, and at our last bargaining, I just wanted to know what was happening for me, because I want to know how that's going to affect me and my family. And so, you know, I was asking questions anytime she would come around, you know, like, what's happening, are we bargaining our benefits yet, like, when are we striking, like, all of that. I wanted to know for me so I could be prepared. And that's when she prompted me, like, you know, you should think about becoming a leader. And again, I didn't see myself that way, so it took a little bit of time for me to actually be convinced and do it. But yeah, I would say definitely stay engaged, Find someone that you trust that you're able to, that's been there for maybe a little longer, that you're able to ask questions to, or a steward, and yeah, definitely attend the events. I know that now we get text messages, make sure you read those, emails, just stay engaged.
And I agree with you both, you know, learning your contracts, right, both of them. The national agreement, right, understanding that, and it drives everything else. That's in working with the coalition. And then your local agreement, right? Your collective bargain agreement, that purple book. Having both of those, and now you can do it online, right? You can download it on your phone or PC, laptop. But to have those in that occasion, be able to open it up and just look at it at your free time, the different sections that are within there. So it talks about the categorization, classifications, right? Disciplines. So these are things that, you know, I would tell them to get familiar with. And also, the very important thing is to stay engaged. Just like you stated, stay engaged, ask questions, participate, right? And find out who your leaders are, right? And if nothing else, the union is all of us,
right?
So participation, active participation is always welcome.
Right, because it's even to the smallest part, because everybody kept saying seniority. That was a word that was being thrown around when I first got, what is a seniority situation? Right. Like, you know, I was small on the totem pole, so it was like, okay. But all the way to vacation or just everything, you know. So the learning the contract it holds value to your employment status.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and just to go back to what like Garfield was saying, that, you know, we are leaders and we've decided to take that step, but at the end of the day, we're all a union. So the more that we all know the contract, the better we can help uphold it, you know, because we're all, I guess I would say maybe responsible is like too much of a word, but like, you know, we're all responsible for making sure that we are educated and we know what's in that contract in the case that it ever affects us or anyone that we know, that we're able to speak up and uphold it.